lectures were well articulated, and in case of copyright, there was no greater example than plagiarism. Libel is subject to the criterion of intentional malice, though if the subject was genuine to write anything, it would also allow that person without penalty. Regarding the issues of privacy, the three areas that were off limits would really not be allowed to be included are most corporate publishing councils, restrictions of alcohol and drug consumption, statements regarding the legitimacy of children, and location of intimate details of the subject's life. And speaking from personal experience, I was once the editor of a biography of writer John Steinbeck, in which the author wrote that Steinbeck's second wife, Carol, had tormented him with the statement that he was not the father of their children. Dr. Biographer felt this keen to understand his son and his novel needs to be. Even though the author stated that the woman's allegation was false, we were not allowed to the threat of a lawsuit by the children to include that back in the book. More recently, there was a suit brought against the publisher Elvin A. Hoffman, who cites his author, Nicholas Lehman, a journalist on the Columbia School of Journalism, the provost, for the publication of his book, The Promised Land, The Great Black Migration, and How It Changed America. Richard Posner, in his decision wrote, I quote, even people who have nothing rationally to be ashamed of can be mortified by the publication of intimate details of their lives. Most people in no wise are formed or disfigured, but nevertheless be deeply upset if new photographs of themselves were published in a newspaper or a book. They feel the same way about photographs of their sexual activities, however normal, or about a narrative of those activities, or about having their medical records publicized. The desire for privacy, that Posner wrote, illustrated by these examples, is a mysterious but deep fact about human personality that deserves and in our society receives legal protection. The other legal issue, such as my concern in the basement of the 1960s, is that of the Pentagon Papers, which the reporter Daniel Ellsberg in the New York Times was found innocent for releasing and publishing government documents related to the war in Vietnam that had come under Ellsberg's possession, which the government argued should not be made available to the public. The Supreme Court's decision to allow publication of these documents was a landmark decision for publishing freedom and for societal access to